morning, al-Bahra sat down with Chief Foreign Affairs Correspondent Margaret Warner in New York.
Mr. al-Bahra, thank you for joining us.
Thank you.
President Obama, the U.S. Congress have now committed to train and equip the rebel forces you represent and assist in other ways, including airstrikes. What do you need most immediately and how soon?
Immediately, we need to have a clear strategy, clear planning on how to start this program as fast as possible. We need to identify what type of equipment needed to fight this war. So actually, this is one of the main purposes of our visit to the U.S. right now, to have a fresh start, correct start of this program. We need weapon systems which can compete with whatever in the hands of ISIL forces, not to be supplied with inferior weapon system. So we need to fight a war where really we are in equal basis, at least with ISIL in weapons and training.
How soon do you want to see U.S. airstrikes employed?
They should be employed as soon as possible because, as you see now, only in the past week, there are thousands of refugees who fled from Kurdish villages and towns inside Syria towards Turkey. This morning I had a call. More than 130,000 refugees really fled from these areas.
Now, you're really engaged in a two-front war. You're fighting not only the Islamic State or ISIS, you're fighting the Assad government. Once you get this new training and equipping and weapons, and you have the benefit of U.S. airstrikes, are you going to focus all of that against the extremist forces, or are you also going to use that new capability against the Assad government?
You know, at war, you don't have the freedom of choice or options. You will be fighting and defending yourself against whoever really having offensive against you. So we will be, for sure, fighting the two fronts at the same time. But more resources would be given right now on ISIL front because really it's a real threat and creating a humanitarian crisis at catastrophic level.
But given the U.S. desire to stay out of the civil war between your forces and the Assad government, you're not making any commitment to not use some of this increased capability against government forces.
You need to go back to the root of the issue. The root of the issue that you have a dictatorship in Syria which built up a strategy of using the card of terrorist organization and terrorism in order to stay and hang into power. So they are the main cause of this issue. If we put them on the side and deal only with the symptoms, you will have the cause already in place, which will produce more terrorist organization in time.
Are your forces positioned to move in and seize ISIL, ISIS-held territory if U.S. airstrikes are employed to weaken them?
Sure. As we speak now, there is a whole front in Aleppo near Mariah town where the ISIL forces stand in front of the Free Syrian Army units. So we are fighting them already on the ground.
Now, there is concern in the United States that right now, though, the Free Syrian Army, your forces, are fighting alongside the al-Nusra Front, which has as its target U.S. and Western interests. What do you say to that?
The Free Syrian Army are by themselves standing alone under one command and control, while al-Nusra forces, they are separate from these command and control.
But are you denying that you all are cooperating, coordinating in some fashion with al-Nusra at this moment?
It's not coordination or cooperation, but it's a fact on the ground. If al-Nusra held one area and we have advances within other areas which near this area, there is no coordination, but there's facts on the ground. Either they don't hit these forces or this force doesn't hit them. You make decision on the battle according to the urgency of the matter.
How likely is it that U.S. airstrikes against the Islamic State extremists will also benefit Assad's forces?
Assad forces, they will try to fill the gap. If ISIL forces withdraw from an area, they'll try to go and inside these areas. But I don't think they will have a chance because we have prepared our own forces to fill these gaps. This we will make sure by our own forces while you do the air attacks that our ground forces would be advancing on the ground and doing the groundwork. But this would be coupled also by a social and economical program to govern the areas which ISIL will withdraw from.
After pleading with the international community for 2 to 3 years for help, how confident are you now have it?
I think now the whole world and the international community has realized the threat, the real threat that extremist organizations similar to ISIL would be on the international community itself. It's not a Syrian issue anymore. So the way we look at it, that we are not joining the coalition is joining our war against extremist and terrorist organizations.
How long will you need the active support of the United States and other members of the coalition to finish the job?
I expect if we do it right, as I said, 1 year you see immediate results, you see a really degrading capability of ISIS, and within 2 years you will see more stabilization, and I expect if we do it correctly, within 3 years we'll forget about the existence of the organization of ISIL. As you know, Al-Qaeda, you fought against it since 15 years ago, but still they exist until now because the approach was wrong. We need to have the right approach from now, from the start.
Mr. al-Bahra, thank you so much.
Thank you.